Some 250 million sperms at a time are sent to the mother's womb. This number is deliberately kept high because as soon as the sperms enter the mother's body, they find themselves facing lethal dangers. There is a dense mixture of acids in the mother's reproductive organs designed to combat bacteria. This acid mixture is also fatal to sperms. Within a few minutes, the walls of the womb are coated with millions of dead sperms. A few hours later, most of the 250 million sperms will have died. This acid compound, which is most important for the mother's health, is so powerful that it can comfortably destroy all the sperms that enter the womb. In that event, fertilization could not take place, and the human race would come to an end. But God, who created the sperms, has also created precautions against the dangers that they will face in the mother's womb. While sperm is being produced in the man's body, a basic compound is added to the fluid that contains the sperms. This compound partially eliminates the effect of the acid in the mother's womb. Thanks to this, a number of sperm has passed the mother's womb and managed to reach the entrance to the fallopian tube. If you'll notice, the sperms all travel together in the same direction. But how do they find this right direction? How do they know where the egg, no larger than a speck of dust, is? The sperms find the way to the egg because another perfectly created biological system comes into action. The egg gives off a chemical signal to attract the sperms, which are about 15 centimeters away from it. The sperms head straight to the egg thanks to this signal. In short, the egg cell, which knows nothing about the sperms and has never come into contact with them before, calls them to it. Two cells, perfect strangers to one another, engage in communication. This reality is another proof that egg and sperm are created in the most ideal form for each other.